Welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, we have to talk, and you already know what we have to talk about. You see, the incident that happened over there in Horizon Park, as I said in the first video I did on it, no matter what you think about police, you should be very worried. Because if that could happen to members of the security forces, imagine unarmed, law-abiding civilians. People of Jamaica, we could talk about this. Early Light crew, Patreon squad, watch but never comment crew, every crew, we need to reason amongst ourselves as a team. This is serious. First, we could just brush over some more details that have now been clarified. Right now, the individual, the main trigger man seems to be a man by the name of Damian Hamilton. Right, and it says on Nationwide that he was deported from Canada a few years ago. Right, man, he's actually a former member of the US Marines. Right, so it seems he spent time in America and Canada. Right, now, people of Jamaica, listen and listen to me carefully. Remember in my video on the Tivoli incursion, who remembers? This is why I'm like reasoning people who actually follow the channel and watch video by video. Do you remember why I said the security forces, especially the police, did not take more losses in the incursion? Who remembers what was the reason I gave for that? Do you remember? Because 87 octanes can't shoot. Who remember that? Refresh your memory, yeah? I said, if 87s could have shoot, go back and listen to the video if you don't believe me, right? If 87s could have shoot, the police and security forces in general would have taken major losses, but instead there were three members of the JCF who were killed and one member of the JDF, and that is the entire garden, plus money come from St. James, plus money come from Clarendon, man from all board get around, and they could only kill three members of the JCF and one member of the JDF. This brother here, right, also Damian Hamilton, one former US Marine, just did more damage. If you're going to talk about being efficient, one US Marine, ex-US Marine, just did more damage than the entire West Kingston. Put that in your pipe and smoke it. People of Jamaica, I'm going to try to put it in a context. When we tell them that 87s can't shoot, and the reason why enough police not lose them life, and when I hear more police drop out, is because they're going up against men who, even though they are heavily armed, they lack the training to really inflict damage on the security forces. This right here, so, is Jamaica's worst nightmare. Now we see in real life what happens when somebody who actually know what they might do challenge members of the security forces. Now I'm going to play some voice note. And I'm going to start the voice of the device note as well, right? But I just want to touch on some things as I play it. Now, people, listen up.
Targeted operation this morning. Got one premises at Horizon Park in a Spanish Town. When them reach our premises, greeted with gunfire. Five police were shot. Two dead. Them just confirmed. So one third one dead. Imam Clunis is back with the life. Them rush Clunis gone at theater. So a three dead out of five, you know.
Those are the words of a member of the Jamaica Constabulary Force sitting on a body upon the road, right? So you heard him that say a three of them gone, right? That's what I also heard, but I'm also hearing that he's actually on a machine, right? I'm not actually gone yet. So we're still waiting, right, to see what will come, right, officially, if they're going to announce that the third person actually has lost his life, right? So we have a whole lot on that, but even the police, everybody has been saying that three people gone, right? So again, remember, the entire West Kingston, Tivoli incursion, three police lost their life. In one day, one operation, two confirmed, possibly three members of the JDF, of the JCF, are gone. People, this is the key part of the voice note more than people them listen to. Check this out.
Yes, the man them plan an operation. ESM on them plan to operate. There's a plan operation for this morning. See, the man I'm supposed to call we done get briefing already and them tell me say we're supposed to go up on the apps. But what going is that 1:30 a.m. when we're supposed to go up on the apps. Our operational team chase one vehicle with four boys for a white axle and the vehicle crashed. So that took up a lot of time. In the time where them said we're supposed to go up on the apps. So it looked like SP Clooney come with theme team from over ESM. And we don't know who him take and go up on the operation. Oh, the information I will get is that when them our upstairs building and them clear the building. The man them open up the grill and let in the police them and them clear the building. And when them clear the last room, them clear majority of the building and one room left. And when them a go for clear the build the last room there, somebody inside the room turn on one high power weapon. Chief person get shot. One who is native to St. Catherine North. And another youth who the base at ESM, him come from Mobile originally. And they up here. Them two they succumb. SP Clooney get shot in his shoulder and in foot. And them said that his injuries are serious. Because he don't know a rifle. And one piece of shoot up one brother. So I think the man said the hombre get to him.
So that right there come from the words of another member of the security forces who was supposed to be on this operation. Now, before we go into the actions of Superintendent Clooney, we could pick out the things them where him say. Now he said the man them open up the grill and let them in. Did you pick up that part? Him said the man them open up the grill and let them in. So there must have been people inside the house, and the original operation was to go there, go pick up keyword men, right? But the man them let them in the house. Now the question I have to ask is, were these people who just so happened to share the building, right? Because this morning whenever you're in a report and nobody get locked up, right? So it's not like say them go there, hold on for wanted the man and them let them in, right? And then go upstairs and start clear the house, right? Instead, we just hear say them get let into the house, start clear the house, and then go upstairs and the man ambush them. Now, let's look at the word ambush, because I heard the commissioner of police say it's not an ambush. This man is a major general, so I'm wondering if he's just trying to save face and make, you know, don't make it sound as bad as it really was, because I'm sure a major general know what an ambush is. People of Jamaica, nobody because they hear the word bush and things that have happened in the bush. All an ambush is somebody laying in wait, right? Wait till you come, but them can't see you, right? You can't see them, and them engage you first and catch you completely off guard. That's all an ambush is, you know? Catch you off guard. Somebody there somewhere and wait for you, right? You turn up, them engage you, you never see it coming. That's all an ambush is, you know? So when the commissioner of police, I go say, it wasn't an ambush, what is he really saying? Is he trying to say that the man them did see him and then five JCF officers then proceeded to get into a long firefight and then the guy came out the victor? If that is the case, that makes JCF look even worse. Come on, people. If the commissioner of police was trying to save face and make things look good and smooth over things, he ended up having the opposite effect. Betian did say, well, it was an ambush and the man never see it coming. But if you are going to tell me say it's not an ambush, when clearly it obviously was the man lay away at them, right? He was upstairs, he knew them come up, right? And he take them on as soon as he see them. It looked like say, them barely with a chance for shoot back. It looked like them barely even giving a chance to respond. Maybe a one run go off because he get injured, right? But if the commissioner of police say it's not an ambush, it's a firefight. So you mean to tell me say five JCF officers got into a firefight with one ex-marine, one US ex-marine, and they came out on the losing side. Because again, condolences to the family, but they came out on the losing side. So if the police commissioner go tell me say it wasn't an ambush, this make the JCF, this make the operation, this let the team led by Superintendent Clooney look even worse. But then they say it was an ambush out and the man couldn't see it coming and one of them thing there. And even tell me say they actually had a firefight and they exchanged rounds and the man did this to them. And all him pick up was apparently him got injured but him still managed to get away. People of Jamaica, think about that for a second. Think about that for a second. So I'm asking a question. What would have happened if it was an ex-Navy SEAL? What would have happened if it was an ex-Ranger? An ex-Delta? What would have happened if it was an ex-British SAS? British SBS? Pathfinders? What exactly would have happened then? People, talk to me. I wonder if the Commissioner of Police hear what he's saying to the Jamaican people. I wonder if him really pick up the message him convey, right? The underlying message when him convey. An ex-marine is able to get into a firefight with five members of the JCF and come out on the winning side. And not only that, he managed to survive, leave, and go to a next location in Accordville where now the elite JCF go for him, right? SWAT team and them and they go for him, elite police in Jamaica. Go for him. And what was the result there? Yes, he lost his life, but guess what? He also injured two other officers there. That's six police in total. One US ex-marine. Six. People of Jamaica think about that. And down at Corville, all him did have was already had two handguns. A handgun him have at Corville. And he went up against the full might of the special JCF cops, and him still managed to injure two of them. This does not look good. Serious questions need to be asked. And me hear the police commissioner say, oh, when somebody asked him what happened here, he said, well, what happened here is there are people with high powered rifles in Jamaica. Listen, I've heard the title of Captain Obvious, but you see, like now we have Major General Obvious. This bigger than Captain Obvious. Commissioner, we know that. Commissioner, we know, say, Monday enough with iPod rifle, we know that. That's not the man ask you what happened. Give you a better answer than that. You tell what the obvious for. And matter of fact, the facts that only know that make it even worse that this up take place. It make it even worse, say, the man them get led like lambs to the slaughter. But I'm sorry, questions still have to ask. So how many men do you need for one US ex-marine? You've heard the saying, how many people need to change the light bulb? How many JCF officers do you need for one US ex-marine? Right? Because about five of them got injured according to the voice note, or four get shot. So tell me, even though we can say, well, okay, Clooney should have waited and him should have got a bigger team. Okay, fine. But how big is the team we are talking about? 100 man? How much man should I wait for? How much JCF man them should I go down with? 30? 40? That me that like for now. People of Jamaica. The reason why I only can't celebrate this. The reason why I'm telling you is that, listen, no matter how you feel about police, check on yourself if you want to go celebrate this. You know why? Because if this one brother could do this to JCF, imagine what I'm going to do to you. Imagine what I'm going to do to your family. Oh, you think your little license going to go help you? Or you think your license firearm, you go up and rain, you go pie, every now and then I go help you? Or you know, just see what I'm going to do to JCF at two separate locations. People of Jamaica, understand this. This brother is not alone. He might be rogue, but there are literally, thousands of Jamaicans who are ex-US Marines, ex-US Army, ex-British Army, ex-Royal Navy, ex-Canadian military. Thousands. So if one could do this damage, imagine if 10 go rogue. Just 10. Worse if all 10 link up together. People of Jamaica, this is why I'm telling you, you can't laugh and celebrate them things. This is serious. You don't have to think and ask these questions. One do this. Right? Now, even if there were more men in the house, him challenge them. And him left, go Coalville, go take the man again. Then go for him at Coalville, and him still managed to injure two more. People of Jamaica, this is serious business. This is why every man, him have to make sure the video drop unless me just can't do it. This is why I tell you, I will not just sit back and just say, yeah, well, I saw it go. I'm sorry, we can't make the country, but we can't lose the country. We cannot lose the country. Right? You know, some people can laugh and kiss anything and say, we don't want a body born our movement. That's fine. Cool. People of Jamaica, if we can deter one youth, if we can deter one youth from going in our life, a crime is a success. If this movement can deter one youth, one Jamaican youth, from picking up a gun and living a life like this, then for me, that is success. I can't believe it. This is not a good look for JCF. I'm just putting it out there. The moral of the officers in the JCF right now is completely destroyed. It was already destroyed from Mogoron and West Kingston. Right? It was already destroyed when the man after run left them Jeep. And now the man them comes to where I'm to them squaddy over in Horizon Park. But you know whose morale is high? Criminals. Are there criminals out there? I go say, what? Then yeah, the man do this. And then now that one brother do this. I remember one of the criminals out there. Remember one of the 87s out there. Nobody thinks they are sure this. Not because you see, Damien Hamilton do this. Go take up yourself and try this. You probably go dead. Because only can shoot like that. Right? Think about these people. Run at West Kingston. Again, I put it out there. West Kingston man them corner the police. Right? And engage them. And the police they manage to forget it. Even though they can say, well, they run. Then tuck them tail and run. Fine, but the point is not even a scratch them get. And that was a bugger man from Garden. That shows a one trained and determined individual is more effective than a bugger 87s. Hey, say it all the time. When I can't say, I react my rock, I say it all the time. Once the man them can shoot, you know, I go see, we go on to Jamaica. At them time, we go start have serious problems. And 87s, even 87s now are moving from the AK and them rifle. That. M16, M4, AR-15 at them type of platform that the man them use. People of Jamaica, please, no big one. We cannot lose this country. We cannot lose this country. We cannot have a society where people think they can do things like this willy-nilly and not knock them out of it. Listen, tomorrow morning, I'm sure information will come out. This and that might change. That is the nature of news. Things evolve all the time. Let me say again, condolences to the family. I demand them where lost them life, right? But people, you see how fast the man go for them? Constable Ricardo Hilton and Corporal Lane Biggs, the two confirmed, right? We just want to put them name out here again. But people, you see how fast the man go for them? I've said that as well. If police really want to come for you, if police motivated to catch man, then catch them, you know? If police really decide to go for certain man, then people, not even a day, it take for them catch the man. Not even a day. And now we're here, said there actually there are other people involved and them got garden tone and all kind of things. By tomorrow morning them things are clear. But we just want to see how fast police catch them. Because they were motivated. Because them look on it like say, you hurt my teammates, you hurt my squaddies. So the day can't done before we go for you. People of Jamaica, this is serious. Very serious. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.